In today's data-driven world, we collect information from all sorts of systems, and often, this data is stored in matrices. To understand the data and draw conclusions, we calculate statistics on these matrices. For example, here we have a matrix of students' test scores for the past semester. The rows represent the students' grades, and the columns represent the different tests. We like to analyze how students performed in the course by calculating the class average for each test, the test average for each student, and finally, the average test score for the entire course. Let's start with our first goal to calculate the average for each test. We use the mean function to determine the average. But what happens when we use it on our matrix? We get a 1x3 vector which contains the average for each column of the matrix. Since the columns represent the different tests, we get the average for each test with this command. Perfect. Statistical functions, such as the mean function, treat each column of a matrix as a separate data set. This means no matter how many columns our data has, we will get the statistics very quickly. Our next goal is to find the test average for each student, so we need the average along the rows instead of down the columns. How can we do this? We control the direction of the operation by passing an additional argument to the mean function. The value 2 indicates that the average will be calculated along the second dimension. So here, the result is a 4x1 vector with the average for each corresponding row. Our last goal is to calculate the average test score for the entire course. So we want to use the mean function on our matrix to get a single value as the result. We could do this by invoking the mean function twice, but this will not work for all statistical functions. A better way is to index using a colon. This turns the matrix into a single column, so that when we take the mean of that vector, the result is the average for the whole matrix. Of course, there are other statistics we might be interested in. For example, let's find the maximum, minimum, and the standard deviation, just to name a few. Most of these functions work just like the example we covered here. Try them for yourself and check the documentation for additional options.